So some of these title search examines, they have many documents that they make accessible to the public, and they can access also from the public. So everything the title abstractors would try to analyze, and so then the title abstracts, as it says, it's an abstract of all the information that is available. In the same way as you are writing a book or a report, and you have an abstract, a conference paper, you have an abstract which will give an indication of what's in the main document, which will make it easier for people who need that information to determine whether or not to go and check the details, or can take it on face value as reported in the data abstracts. So, again, in the United States, these are within particular states, and they operate within those state boundaries. And so it might be good, or it might be possible, that something from one state spills over in another state. And so you have to check, keep checking the states, the different states, to see if there is anything which is relevant in one state, which might be relevant also in another state. This is a problem with professionals providing services. Because they are trusted, then this allows people, or gives people, the confidence in taking their advice. Unfortunately, we have Barclays Bank having its investment section. In its investment section, gave advice to a couple who wanted to put their money, or had the intention of putting their money in commercial property. They went to the investment wing to ask for advice, and they got the advice that it's okay, it's quite good to invest in this property. And so they went and put all their monies into the property. Unfortunately, when we had the subprime fiasco, the value of the property fell enormously, and these people lost. They sued Barclays, and the court upheld their claim, and so Barclays was fined. They had to pay. So the professional indemnity insurance will pick up the suit, or the cost of the suit, or the cost of the defense for these professionals. So it is advisable that these professionals then will have the insurance program. Many organizations provide professional indemnity insurance for their workers. And so one of the requirements, the new requirements, for UK employment law is for this type of insurance to be provided for all workers, and there must be evidence that this is provided. So anything that is missed, can these people can be then taken care of. In other words, the insurance will ensure that the suit is their responsibility. And the defense of their integrity would also be part of the coverage for that professional indemnity insurance. So, some people can use fraudulent attempt to subvert the real information, to falsify the information. Some of the searches are wholly or partially inaccurate, and therefore they also need to be insured to ensure that they are protected. So, we talk about the equity. The suit by the couple who wanted to invest, it was about equity. If you think that it is worth spending this money, and that the prospect of gaining an improvement in its value, representing the equity, then you're taking an advice which says it's fine. There's unlikely to be a downturn. But the person was only looking at current market rates and predicted market rates, which had not taken care of, had not taken into account pestle factors. The pestle factors are the political factors. We're looking at what is likely to happen. We just had a general election in the United Kingdom. If the Labour Party assumed power, if the Conservative Party assumed power, and what is the likelihood of Conservative being defeated in the House of Commons? What is the likelihood of the Conservative Party being defeated at the polls? If Labour Party assume power, it would be a completely different political, which would have effect on economic factors. Labour Party had promised to tax, increase corporate taxation, provide better welfare, abolish student loan, improve the country's infrastructure, retake, renationalize the rail and utilities. Now, our forecast, our predictions should then take account of the implications that these political insights or political ambitions will have on these economic factors. The economic factors, we're looking at just about everything that is happening or is likely to happen. And we call it Brexit, which is Britain exiting the European Union, which is more than just an economic union. It's an economic and political union. So we have moved from simply single market, we have moved from just custom union to a complete economic union, where most countries are using the same currency. We're using the same tariff for all countries. We all agree on that. And we have a free trade alliance. We are paying money for social programs in all the different countries. We are, as a union, we're also backing each other. So if one central bank fails, the other central banks can assist with a fund, a loan, guarantee. So we have the euro, and the euro does say something. We have ECOWAS, which is of which you are part, but which is not a fully fledged economic and political union. But how soon, or how often, or if and when it will get there is for other people to think about. Okay. So, yeah, we have the GCC, which is the Gulf Cooperation Council, which represents the customs union, which has not gone too far in terms of political union yet. And social. What are the social factors? And what's the social fabric like? Is the social fabric likely to change? And very, very simple examples is, are people taking more, or will take more, to social media? Are people going more mobile? And so Google penalizing organizations or websites that don't have a mobile version, because people are more and more going on their phones online, and they don't have time, or they don't have the means of doing that. Are they moving away? Will they move away from social media? Will they move away from shopping online? And so Amazon has just bought a retail chain, food retail. And not only might they sell food to be delivered by orders online, but they're beginning to have physical shops, stores, supermarkets. These are already in existence. They will continue. So where is the move? Are they shifting? So companies, when you get a forecast, when you get any information, it's telling you how valuable that land, that property is going to be if you invest because of all these factors. Is it likely to go down? Is the price of the real estate likely to fall? It might fall because of the political issues. Do they plan to reduce the tax on real estate? We talk about community charge, business rates, property taxes generally. Is that going to rise to an all-time high? Are we going to have a gradual relaxation in order to encourage investment? Technological factors which have made land registry and revenue authority more effective, and that can improve productivity. How is all that affecting the advice that we give? So we can bring this technology to bear on the way that organizations operate. environmental factors? Are we, what are we concerned about with respect to the environment? Are we looking more of renewable energy? Are we looking at nuclear-free energy? Are we looking at fossil-free energy? Are we more concerned about solar energy, or wind-powered energy, or water turbine energy, or geothermal energy? What environmental factors? So do we believe, or do we subscribe to the climate change camp or fad? What are the legal factors? And we just had Trump announcing yesterday, last night, some of the legal changes in its relationship with Cuba. We have a problem with the relationship between Iran and the United States and the rest of the world. We have legal factors affecting Qatar with the other GCC nations having an embargo. This is a legal factor, so you are not supposed to say anything which would sympathize with Qatar, or it is 15 years in prison by the UAE government. So all of these have to be taken into account. So these are, we call, external, uncontrollable issues. And so we can only circumvent them, but we cannot change because they are beyond our control. But we can take measures. Now, all these advice that I've been referring to, and all your operation, will have to take cognizance of these environmental factors. So, we say the proliferation of these searches and the need to continue to search, compile information, abstract information, has also given rise to the popularity of these insurance companies. This is also an era of taxation. Revenue authorities. So insurance companies are going to be taxed on their relationships with these people and the monies that they collect. Okay, so if we skip this for a few moments, and we'll come back to it. I think after lunch we'll do that. So we'll have a video there, and if you just note that for me, please, so that we remember that. So the title is a property title and property deeds. So it's going to be an example of that there. The duration is just about 15 minutes. So just after lunch. I thought of, and we mentioned this earlier, surface rights as opposed to mineral rights. And in the US, we have a separation of these. So one person might own the surface, and another person might